Well, it has been just over 40 years since Kathy Lette captured what life was like in so many Aussie suburbs with her autobiographical teen novel, Puberty Blues. The gal from Sydney Shire has continued to shock and amuse her readers, and her latest book is no exception. Kathy joins us from her home in London. G'day, beautiful. How are you?
Hello, darlings. I wish I was there. Having talk with you in the studio. I'm so jealous.
You were supposed to have a launch and you were going to be carried into it by sailors.
Well, today's my book launch, right? And it's true. We're going to have a big pool party. I was going to be carried in by these gorgeous love gods in their budgie smugglers, you know, holding me aloft, covered in sequins, and, well, nothing. This is my book launch. I've put my books up. I've had a cocktail and this is it.
So, I love it.
Only one?
Sulking. My sulking face.
Only one?
Well, it is 1:30 in the morning here.
Now, Kathy, I do remember by the Boy Charlton Pool some years ago, you did a book launch there and you were carried in by these gorgeous guys in their budgie smugglers, all the lifesavers. Are you doubling up? Come on.
It seems to be a running theme, doesn't it?
Doesn't it?
And I remember we weren't making small talk either.
This book, Kathy, I finished reading Husband Replacement Therapy last night and I absolutely love it. Congratulations. It follows Ruby. It follows Ruby, who, while celebrating her 50th birthday, decides to tell her family and friends what she really thinks of them. Now, how much of you is in Ruby? Have you ever got a tad truthful after a few champers, a bit of in vino veritas?
I think I have, and I think I did it with you as well. So, yeah. I mean, if I have any gift as a writer at all, it's putting into words what women are thinking but not necessarily saying out loud. And, of course, girl talk is really, really funny. And I don't know why some men – I'm published in about 19 languages, so I've been on book tour in many countries in the world. And there will always be some guy who will say – some journalist will say, well, you know, you say you write funny books, women aren't that funny. And I think, why do some men still say that? I think they're terrified what it is we're being funny about. They think we spend the entire time talking about the length of their members, which is not true, because we also talk about the width, you know, which after childbirth. But when I've been on a girls' night out with both of you, and you have to be hospitalized from hilarity, don't you?
Yes.
When women get together, our humor is so candid, it's so cathartic, it's so confessional, and it's hilarious. So I try and capture that in my books. And also, at the moment, have we ever needed a laugh more? I mean, they say that laughter is the best medicine. It's the only medicine we have right now. So it's a good time to be bringing out a book that's going to bring some cheer, I hope.
I agree. Because I just loved the line when I was reading it. Ruby decides, you know, she admits to her girlfriend she doesn't want children. And she was going to go home that night after dinner and tell them.
That's right, absolutely. I know, I mean, all mums at the moment are going so crazy because what they've realised now that you can't, if you're lucky enough to have a cleaner and you can't have a cleaner now, you're realising how little men are doing around the house, nor are they helping with the homeschooling. All the men I know who are supposed to be homeschooling, they've chosen PE, which is where they go outside and get the kids to ride up and down the street on a bike while they play games on their phone. You know, so the advice I would give to any man out there, if he doesn't want to be divorced straight after the lockdown, you've got to get better at housework, which is in his interest because it's scientifically proven that no woman ever shot her husband while he was vacuuming, right? True. And the other I would say do some cooking because the way to a woman's heart is through her stomach. That's not aiming too high. Mm. Men always say to me, what do women really want in bed? Breakfast, breakfast. It's not that hard, is it? No.
But you have a whole life, apart from your brilliance as an author, you have a big life. In fact, you know Julian Assange. You've actually had him in your home in London. Well, you know, we'd like to know exactly what he's like.
Right. Well, I mean, I feel desperately sorry for Julian. I think it's terrible what's happening to him. He's going to end up in a supermax in America for sure. And all he really did was publish. And I know he's a very controversial character, but when he was staying with me, I've got to explain that married to a human rights lawyer for 28 years, we had a lot of very interesting house guests. Mm-hmm. You know, we had Sam Rushdie was staying here during the fatwa years. It's now more of a thinwa, I'm happy to say. we've had We've had exiled poets, you know, prime ministers who were banned from their countries. We've had prisoners on the run. I had James Hewitt. He was in the attic hiding for a while when the press were looking for him and the palace wanted to put him on trial for treason for having the affair with Di. I've had Julian Assange. I've had everyone in my attic except Anne Frank, basically. Now, I can say that Anne Frank would laugh at that. She had a good sense of humour. But Julian, when he came to stay, he was hiding up there. So I did get to know him very well. And what I would say about him is that he's on the autistic spectrum, undiagnosed. And I have a son with autism, as you know. So I have a good antenna for these things. And I think that's why he's got into so much trouble socially. He's just sort of said the wrong thing or been no filter, you know, hasn't handled social situations well, which is, I think, what happened in Sweden. Most of that was just misunderstanding. So, you know, I do have a lot of sympathy towards him. And, you know, in fact, I got to know him so well that when the Simpsons were doing their 500th episode and they wanted to do a cameo, have Julian as the cameo, they asked me to write his dialogue. You can imagine for any writer getting asked to write for the Simpsons was the ultimate accolade. So I did write a funny episode, his scenes in that show. But they cut out my favourite line. I had this great line where Julian Assange is doing the barbecue and Marge comes over and she tries the marinade and she loves it and she asks him for the recipe, to which he replies, "I'm sorry, but I never reveal my sources."
Oh, why would they cut that?
Kathy, the last time I saw you in the flesh was actually in church at Westminster Abbey with heaps of members of the royal family, including Harry and Meghan. What do you make of Megxit?
Oh, I mean, I can't believe that people are still obsessed with this. I mean, after Corona, it just seems so insignificant. I think, look, Harry and Meghan, I just think they've lost their sense of humour. I think you can't go through life suffering from an irony deficiency. You've got to, especially if you've anything to do with the royal family, you've got to be able to banter and, you know, roll with the punches and all those sorts of things. So I fear they're going to be cast off into social Siberia. You know, I just wish we could take Meghan on a girls' night out. That's what she needs.
Hey, and yeah. Just sort of if anybody can do it, you can. I'm with you.
We should invite her out. You know, just loosen her up a little bit. I think because I think I think they must be using Prince Andrew's advisor right now because it's all totally pear-shaped, isn't it?
Because he's in demand. Yeah, whoever that advisor is. Kathy, as I said, I read the book over the weekend. Absolutely loved it. Husband Replacement Therapy is out now, and do yourself a favour. It's perfect reading material for self-isolation. You'll be laughing out loud. Kathy Lette, always gorgeous talking to you.
I love you, girls. Ange, thank you for saying those lovely things. And I'm sending you a big kiss, and we will swing from a chandelier with a toy boy between our teeth very soon, I'm sure.
Oh, I think promises, you are. Promises. I love it.